rifles. Wolves of Rebellion. Use of this features look cavalry weapons. US Navy weapons. Oh, that's cool. A cutlass pistol. Soldier. More unit infantry weapons. This is old ammunition. Like cannonballs and stuff. Right, I've just had to change to my phone for the time being because my camera's too hot, so I'll let it cool down a little bit. Pistols. Yeah, so sorry about the change in quality. Phone is in on my phone, my camera's cooled down, I'll start using it again. Look at all these really old weapons. Primary and secondary arms. I can actually feel the heat of the camera in my pocket, so I know it's really, really hot. I'm not surprised it's hot because it has been recording for like 2 hours nearly. Conversions and alterations. A Gatling gun. If you want to attempt to pause and read. Thank you. pocket pistols. Bizarre looking ones. Really cool looking. You got your automatic one, 1902, and they made guns like that. Fort Reno. Evolution of ignition systems. Cartridges, lead balls. And you got the ones we've got today. Spanish-American War. World War One. Japanese weaponry. This is what the Japanese had. The Japanese top tag was wood. Who'd have thought? Browning machine gun. World War Two. Some really cool looking weapons. British light machine gun.
increased it quite a bit. Really? She was so, you could tell, he was getting ready to get
Oh, Fifi died.
He did it
for her.
To go get Fifi.
Oh, Fifi paid his life. That's all she wanted to know.
You sit there. You just make sure the paperwork's correct and you tell them what their benefits are. And you move on. They try to flush it out of
your brain. Yeah, forget about that whole interaction.
Because it is a toilet bowl.
Then later on, isn't it?
Well, down the road, right before I was in the job for a year, and we had an NCO recruit. And how are these are brand new? These are the ones that I'm not here. His girlfriend, other recruiter's girlfriend in the back.
Mm-hmm. You never find yourself in
sounds not fair, but all kinds of
things. Let me say something.
Yeah. I remember from your adventure, the Wilson,
Medal of Honor. Okay, I'm back to this now. I don't know how long it'll last, but I'm kind of running out of time anyway. It's like a chapel they used. Ooh, sniper rifle. Anti-tank grenade. All the inner workings.
The camp served as a model for all later concentration camps and as a so-called school of violence for the SS men who controlled it. The camp existed for 12 years and held more than 200,000 prisoners in the main and subsidiary camps. 21,500 people lost their lives in these camps. On April 29, 1945, the men of the 157th Infantry Regiment, 45th Infantry Division, put Dachau to an end. The 157th Infantry Regiment's battalion command.
Back to his running law again. Let's have a look at the gift shop.
Thank you.
And that concludes the tour of the 45th Infantry Division Museum. Now I'm going to go and sit in the car and relax. Wait until I get in the car and I'll show you what I've got souvenir wise. Highly warm in this car. Right, so as you know, I'm going to be making a little like resin based souvenir of my trip here. So little things I'm picking up, little souvenirs to go in it. So I've picked up, I'm probably going to put one of them in and I'll keep the other one. So I've got that, which is inscribed on the back. The 45th Infantry Division is one of the best, if not the best division in the history of American arms. And there's also a little keyring as well. So either one of those will be obviously made into the resin things. So I'm going to turn this car on because it is absolutely roasting in here. And I need the heat to dissipate so then I can actually relax. So thanks everyone for watching. If you've enjoyed it, then make sure you hit that like button, subscribe if you want to see more content like this, because like I said, I'm going to try and do more of this type of stuff.